I figured out a long time ago, if I control my environment, right, and I create the right routines, kind of anything is possible. Welcome back to the Tom Ferry Show. Today, I want to talk to you about designing your environment, yes, whether you're in a cubicle or a private office, to set you up for high performance sales success. Now, here's what I know. Doing this as long as I've been doing it, your environment does actually impact your ability to be in action, to be fired up, and to produce the results that you want. Now, I'm not saying you need to switch companies or change your office. I'm saying control your environment. You've heard me tell stories before about the past. I can remember my very first apartment, Center Street in Costa Mesa, California. I knew then, even though this street was pretty scary when I lived there, had a bullet hole in my window, which when the sun hit it, did have a very nice reflection on my wall, but it was a bullet hole. And the first 6 months that I was there was actually a death, you know, sadly, right? And I literally saw outside my window the tape of a body. Now, most people would say that was a horrible environment to create success. But you know what I did? I took my room and I converted it into something that helped me become the person I am today. And that's what I want to talk to you about today. And if you ever get the chance to come to our office, whether it's in California or our new location in Dallas, you're going to see that we've set up our environment for everybody that works here to make it high energy, fast paced, lots of fun, and highly productive. So I've got 5 things I want you to think about between now and the end of the year as we go into 2020 of how you can change your environment to make it even better. Whether you're in a cubicle or you're in a private office, it's all the same. So, number one is obvious. We've been talking about business planning. We've been talking about our marketing plans. We've been talking about goal setting. So, there's A, B, C, D, E, F. That's 6 different visuals. You might combine it to 2 or 3 that you should have inside your office. I want you to imagine right here, 1 should be your hours of power and your appointment setting. Now you might say, Tom, I love to track that inside Excel, or I use a Loom, or I use, you know, some other software to track it. I get it, but there's something powerful about writing up there 210 days and I want to book 89 appointments as an example, and having a countdown tracker, 210, 209, 208, 207, you got it, right? And you literally count it down visually. And you know what? When it's up and visual, when it's in your face, it's a scoreboard, just like going to a football game or a soccer match where there's only so much time left, days, and the current score. And when you have that visual scoreboard, you're more inclined to get up there and mark it off and get it done and make it happen. Have it up and visual in your face. The second one, B, is obviously you want to have your active listings and your coming soons. Now, of course, you can do the next one, C, which is your pendings, right? All on that one board. So I've got all my active listings, 1234 Banana Street, 2247 Banana Street, etc. And then my coming soons. I'm working on this one and this one. They're cleaning up the house, etc., etc. Haven't released it to the market yet. Not in the MLS yet. Not for sale yet. Then I want to have my pendings. I've got 3 in escrow. And it's just that constant visual reminder that these people right now are super important. I got to take care of my sellers. I got to manage these escrows. I got to make sure that they're done right and it's up and visual. Make sense? The next one, D, is I believe you should have a visual for the number of transactions you want to close in 2020. And I love when I see clients, when I walk in their office and there's like this big, like almost like a thermometer that says, in 2020, we're committed to helping 72 people buy and sell real estate. And then they've got 72 slots, and every time they close a transaction, the client or they write in their names, right? What a wonderful visual reminder of what it is you're committed to in 2020. So that's another great example. You could do it, like think of like how many agents I've seen that just have a number up there, 36, and it's 36, 35, 34, 33, and they just keep checking them off. But again, could you imagine going to a football game where they didn't keep score and they didn't have a clock to let you know how long it was gonna last? I would argue that'd be a really boring game. But there's something about like in the NBA when there's only 2 minutes left and it's 80-80 and you know the last 2 minutes, it's gotta be crazy. That scoreboarding of your goals is so important to create that emotion to take more action. So again, hours of power and appointment setting, listings that are active and coming soon, and maybe pendings, right? All on that one. Then I want to have my closed sales. We're committed to helping this many people, and the address or the names or whatever you think is right for you. And then of course, the next one is your do, doing, and done board. We talked about this a lot on the Tom Ferry Show. My mentor, Mike Vance, created this while he was working with Walt Disney. And what they did is they always had a lot of ideas. So they needed a visual to put up all the ideas under the do category. Now, just because it was on the board didn't mean they were actually going to do it. It was just an idea that if it was up there next to 50 other ideas, you might say, that one's really cool. But if we combine those two, that'd be even better, right? Then they had their doing, which was, here's the 2, 3, 4 projects we're committed to getting done this month. And then the last one was done. And I have to tell you, for you and I as entrepreneurs, we sometimes forget how much that we do throughout the year. So actually tracking all of the projects that you completed, I redid my listing presentation. You know, I started my video show. I started my geographic farm. I've done all these things. Boy, I tell you, at the end of the year, and sometimes these years feel long, you feel better because you know you're moving the needle and you're getting things done. So I recommend that one. And then the last one, these are just up and visual in your environment, is your monthly marketing plan. All right, here's the 5 sources, right? My database, my geographic farm, my open houses, my online lead generation, my social media marketing, whatever it may be, whatever your sources are, and here's the tasks that have to happen this month. Now, if you've been in my office before, you see that we have dry erase walls where you get the dry erase paint so I can write all over it, and we may just have it all written up there for the month, right? Just like we're tracking everything else. Now, this is where you've got to be resourceful. Because you might say, Tom, I'm in a cubicle environment. Well, what if I told you that I have clients in a cubicle environment that have all those things up in visual? You know what they did? They went and got that fishing line. I don't even know what it's called, Mark. Help me out here. Like fishing string, whatever you use to fish. And you know what they would do? They'd go up and they'd hang it from the lights, and the piece would come down, and there would be their visual tracking board. Yes, they're resourceful. Now, what you don't want to do is have this stuff in your desk drawer. You don't want to have it hidden somewhere on your phone. You want to have it up and visual. Even it has to be at your home office. Get it up, get it visual, because it's that constant reminder that we're in a game called help more buyers and sellers help you achieve your goals, and we got to track and measure everything. So that's number one. I promise you, if you just do that, 2020 will be better. Number two, I think you need to have a living plant inside your environment. I've seen money trees, you know, you can Google this, you see all kinds of fun little things that you can do. But you know what I always think about? Like that living plant that I'm responsible for, you know what I call it? I call it client service. And if you walk in and it actually has written client service on it and the plant is dying, that might just be a reflection of you not paying attention to the little details of your business, like that living plant sitting inside your office. Number three, you ready? I think you should add some positive visuals. Look at, I'm all in, Tom Ferry, let's go, right? Gotta have, hey, it's time to make my phone calls. I got my hour of power. These are little visuals. This is my favorite. One of our masterminds from the East Coast sent me this because they've heard me tell the story of Roe. So sometimes when I'm on coaching calls, I'm like literally saying to clients, like, hey, hello, we got a Roe. You got to make your phone calls. You got to do what you're supposed to be doing every single day. But when you have these little visuals, I go to the 7th floor of my sales team, and you know what they've got? I see them with golf clubs and they're hitting balls around, they're putting. I'm okay with that because you know what it does? It makes the energy and the environment fun. Another one you might want to consider, same exact area. Ready? Add some positive visuals. What if you had a dream board up? What if you had your 2020 vision board or your 10-year goals up in visual? We did this at our last office. We probably need to do it again, talking to my team, where I had everybody put up all of their visual goals in their cubicle, the things that they were willing to have all their, you know, their associates at the office see. And you know what? I'd walk by like Katie, who's with me, you know, forever in customer service, who's lost 150 pounds since she's come to work with us. And I remember seeing that she had on her goal board, she wanted to lose this weight. She wanted to get to a certain size. Katie, if you're watching this video, I love you, congratulations, right? And all of a sudden you see that. Or I see, you know, Lauren over here says, hey, I wanna go to Hawaii and I wanna take this trip. And because it was up and visual, they started to connect the dots between doing my work, achieving my goals, doing my work, achieving my goals. It might be the same thing for you. What is it that's your motive for action? Get it up and visual, make it fun inside your office. Let people know that you're committed to take your family to Hawaii and have that beautiful photo up there as that reminder to make your phone calls, to do the work that ultimately gets you what you want. So that's just a few things to think about, and you can do all kinds of stuff. Number four, I wrote down probably a good idea to get a new headset. I just ordered the new AirBud, the AirBud Pro, that's actually the noise canceling, which, you know, thank you Apple for finally creating this, because I've had those things forever. And guess what? I'm walking through an airport and my wife or whoever I'm talking to hears everything else. Well, it's the same thing when you're inside the office, right? You want to have a great headset that cuts off all the noise around you. So when you're talking to that customer, when you're doing that consultation for that buyer, when you're talking to that potential seller, right, about their goals and what it is that they want to work on, that all that noise is removed. That's a really good idea for you. And the last one, number five, is one of my all-time favorites. I came up with this concept and actually shot a video on it years ago called You Should Build an Appointment Setting Shrine. Now, you know, it'd be really great, because I know some of you might be watching this with your team, at your office, like with a bunch of your buddies at the office. I would be so thrilled if you would send me a photo of your appointment setting shrine. I'd like to see 6 or 7 or 10 or 50 inside the office. Let me explain what it is. I figured out a long time ago, if I control my environment, right, and I create the right routines, kind of anything is possible. So you know what I did? I went to Staples and I bought some of those presentation boards. Right? You know what I'm talking about? Those boards that kind of open up like this, and you know, remember when you were a kid, or you see your kids doing it where they're making a presentation at their school, so they open up the presentation? Well, mine, when I opened it up, if you imagine, over here, I had a photo of a guy named Cal Ripken. Now, Cal Ripken Jr. was a very famous baseball player, and one of the things that made him so extraordinary was the number of games he played in a row. I don't want to quote the number, but it was, you know, north of 2,000 games that he played in a row. And you know what? I had that photo in my appointment setting shrine as the reminder to be that disciplined, to show up every day with inspired action, regardless of what's going on around me, and play my best, which is what he did. So it was a great visual. Over here, guess what I had? A photo of my two boys, right, on vacation, as the reminder that I work hard to go do more memories like that. That I had over here, three or four of the most important goals, the things that I was working towards. We want to buy the new family home, right? We want to, you know, buy a new car for my wife, or whatever it may be. I had all these visual goals. So Cal Ripken, reminder, my children, right, my source of inspiration, all the goals and things that the family and I decided upon. Over here, guess what I had? A mirror, yes, you know, pretty easy with a little super glue, stick the mirror there to remind myself that when I'm on the phone, people feel the smile over the phone. Remember, you only got 5 senses. I know some of you have 6, but you know, most of us, we have 5. And when you're over the phone, you're basically 80% technically ineffective. So with a big smile on your face, and that visual, right, seeing myself, I'm like, oh yeah. And I would, you know, my wife would come in and put lipstick on it and put a big smiley face. It was that reminder to smile. And then in the middle, you know what I had? All of the presentations that I was using, whether it was reaching out to past clients or expired listings or whatever script I needed, all the objection handlers, everything was there. And then you know what? For me, I'd have it on my desk like this. And I made it a bit of a ceremony, right? So I'm like, okay, it's time for me to get on the phone. And it, like, literally, I would light the candle. Not sure if you can do that in your office, but I could do it at the time. And I'd light the candle, and I would literally, like, you know, like, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Appointments. And I would, oh, and I would open this thing up. And I would do it kind of the same way. Yeah, you might say that's kind of corny and silly, but it was like this ceremonial thing of, like, I'm opening this up because now is the time to see Cal Ripken, to remind myself to smile. Here's all my scripts, here's my kids, here's my goals. Get your butt on the phone, make your calls, book appointments, make things happen. And you know what? I had everybody I was gonna call here. I had my phone, my headset, and it was, you know, dialing for dollars, whatever you wanna call it. I don't like to call it prospecting. I call it appointment setting, right? Because, you know, you don't get sales and transactions and happy clients without appointments. So I call it my appointment setting shrine. And when I was done with my hour of power, guess what I would do? Close it, blow out the candle, celebrate the fact that I was done, put it away, and get back into my day. So watch this. 2020 is gonna be entirely up to you. We've talked about your goals. We talked about your business plan. We look back at where you were 10 years ago, where you are now, where you ultimately wanna be. We talked about your finances. Now, the next step is, let's make sure that your environment isn't, you know, dusty and old and crotchety and, you know, your plaque from 43 years ago. Maybe it's time to get something new and something fresh, something that's gonna motivate you and inspire you, especially with all those visual boards all around you, to keep track and keep score of your goals and your success. So, race over to Staples. Get the dry erase boards, get the dry erase paint, have a conversation with your broker because you might be hanging things from the walls or from the ceilings, but make no bones, get it done, because 2020 is going to be bananas if you go all in. See you next week.